broadcast from Philadelphia. It's the home of the 76ers, the Wells Fargo Center. Buckle yourselves in, everybody. It's the NBA on 2K Sports, and here with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan. So here we go, the 76ers to start it. And now the opening lineup for Boston. The speedy backcourt of Rondo and Bradley. Brandon Bass is out there with Green, and it's Sellinger in at the five spot. Rajon Rondo returning to action in mid-January of 2014, a little less than a year after his ACL tear. And Stevie looked pretty good.
He did. His shooting percentages were down, but you know, rebounding and passing as well as he ever has. Rondo, I think this year will be much more effective now that he's got some reps back on that knee.
Richardson, no luck. 76ers on defense. Outside, Green. Green, left side. Rondo on top, and it's a defensive three-second violation.
And Rondo's field goal percentage dipped, but he shot a lot more three-pointers than ever before in his career. Coming off that injury, maybe not looking to drive as much as in the past, he hit that three-point shot at about 29%. I think he's got to get that mark up. If he does, then he could really be lethal.
And he shows the focus there, nails the technical.
And Rondo trying to add range to his shot. Didn't stay idle while he was getting healthy. Seems he rehabbed his shot while rehabbing his knee.
Bass with it. Over in the corner, Green. Six to shoot. And it's Bradley off the drive. Blocked. And he gets it back. Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. Carter Williams dishes to Thompson. Carter Williams with the bucket.
Defense pretty much helpless there stopping that layup. I think too much of a mismatch in terms of height.
And here's Rondo. Outside Bradley. Shoots the three. It's rebounded by Carter Williams.
Kind of a shaky first few minutes, guys. Five field goal attempts, only one made.
Here's Thompson. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. It's going to be on Brandon Bass.
Hollis Thompson is a slender 6'8 swing man out of Georgetown. And, you know, with his quickness and athleticism, I think he's got the ability to defend twos and threes and maybe in time point guard.
Hollis Thompson. And Hollis Thompson with good leaping ability, a nice finisher, Steve, in transition.
Yeah, you know, in the half court, more comfortable moving off the ball for jump shots. But as he develops his ball handling, I think he has a chance to really take advantage of his length and athleticism.
And so Thompson nails both of them.
Hollis Thompson was part of the undrafted Georgetown contingent, getting their chance in Philadelphia last season, playing alongside Henry Sims. And, you know, Thompson shot the ball well, showed a lot of promise as a scoring swingman.
Now, here's Green. Feeds to Bradley. Just five on the clock. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. And Thompson playing solid rotation minutes, shot the ball well, and if anything, could stand to shoot more.
He's got a pretty low scoring rate given his accuracy from all over the court. I think with this quick release, I think he should be looking to shoot it more.
The first one falls.
Avery Bradley out of Texas, one of the elite perimeter defenders in the NBA, a guy who can really give you nightmares bringing the ball up the floor. 6'2", but with long arms, and he can defend both guard positions, really pressures the ball well.
Both free throws good from Avery Bradley.
And despite his 6'2 size, it's pretty clear that
Offensively, Avery Bradley is not a point guard. He's worked hard on developing his ball handling, especially his left hand, but he's certainly at his best when he's playing off the ball.
Offensively, 1 of 4 to start. They're still trying to find their stroke.
Let's send it out to DB, who caught up with head coach Brad Stevens. Doris?
Yes, Kevin, he's certainly mindful of the shot-blocking presence they'll run up against inside. But he doesn't want them shying away offensively. If anything, he said, we've got to be aggressive, but also patient. If we can be deceptive in the way we attack, and there are ways to do that, we can be successful inside. Guys, let's see how successful they can be.
Thanks a lot, Doris. And dealing with the sort of defense they're facing is not an easy challenge.
No, but they've got a few weapons of their own that they can counter with, so it's not exactly a one-sided battle.
Maybe so, Steve, but those weapons are still going to have to perform at a really high level for them to have a chance to be successful.
Here's Green. Philadelphia able to drain the three. 18 feet out, and it's Noel with the rebound. And talk about Bradley playing the two. He's worked to put weight on, up over, what, I think, Steve, 210 pounds, you were saying.
Yeah, looks like it. He looks stronger. He's added some weight. Remember, he underwent surgery on both shoulders a couple of seasons ago, but now he's healthy. And with that strength, with that defensive awareness, with the quickness, he's got the ability to be a really good player.
Here's Rondo, and he lays it up and in. Rondo's got his first basket. The 76ers have gone 2-6 in the field. Carter Williams against Rondo. Embiid kicks to Richardson. Makes it off the glass. Richardson's got 5. For Boston, they've gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. Embiid with the steal. Carter Williams against Rondo. Carter Williams, the pass to Noel. Carter Williams sets a screen for Richardson. Thompson dishes to Carter Williams. Just 5 to shoot. So they take the lead.
Really did a nice job recognizing the mismatch that he had and immediately cashing in with that mid-range jumper.
Boston trailing. Sellinger a screen on Carter Williams. Rondo kicks to Green. Back to Rondo. Outside Bradley. Fires the 3. That one goes. Counting. Bradley's got 7 points.
What a terrific job to get the release perfect that time. I thought it might get blocked or deflected, but nice stroke.
Even with giving up a lot of size in that matchup, still able to get off a nice long-range shot there.
Now, here's Richardson. 5 points in the game. Back to Carter Williams. Releases from 15. Embiid slams it home for the putback.
The lead changes hands once again. There has been no separation between these two teams tonight.
What an intriguing basketball game, that's for sure.
Now here's Rondo. Sellinger with a screen for Rondo. The feed to Bradley. Nice ball movement by Boston. Fires from 14. Here's Sellinger, and he gets the bucket. Guys, no one team gaining control early on.
Give and take, back and forth the whole way thus far.
Yeah, 6 lead changes already, and as Rasheed Wallace once said, both teams playing hard, my man.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here. The 76ers have gotten 5 of 10 shots to drop in this game so far, right at the 50% mark.
Well, you know, head coach Brad Stevens of the Celtics is coaching a much different game in the pros than we see in college. I mean, a lot of differences, but if anybody can make that transition, I really think he's certainly the guy that could. He's bright, he's hardworking, he communicates well, he's innovative, showed that innovativeness at the college level. So I think he's got all of the ingredients to become a college coach who is successful as an NBA coach.
And so it's Boston with it. Philadelphia able to drain the three. They get the rebound. And another shot. And that's 2 points on the layup. Zellinger's got the game tied up here for Boston.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
And Coach Stevens, analytically minded, at Butler had a full-time statistician as one of his assistants.
Yeah, very new school in his approach. You might expect that from such a young guy, still in his 30s. Of course, he also needs to connect with his players. You know, and he's doing well. Despite the losses, the players really enjoyed playing for Stevens. And I think he's going to be an excellent coach.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists.
Now, here's Bradley. 7 points in the game. The drive by Green. Kicks it out to Bradley. 4 on the clock. Good. And it's Rondo who picks up the assist. 10 points for Avery Bradley.
Oh, the rapid-fire threes coming from everywhere.
I thought it might be a little imprudent to try to get those points right back, but it worked.
It's stolen by Green. The pass to Bradley. Outside Rondo. Back to Bradley. Clock at 4. And the wide open shot from Green. And it's Boston with another.
Assisted by Avery Bradley.
Here's Carter Williams. Richardson with the screen on run. Noel sets a screen for Carter Williams. Pass to Noel. Rebounded by the Celtics. Now here's Bradley. Outside Rondo. Zellinger a screen on Carter Williams. Here's Bradley. And another basket for Boston.
This switch has definitely been flipped to on this quarter, guys.
The 76ers trail by 4. And Philadelphia calls time here.
Well, it's been said about Rajon Rondo that he's the smartest guy in the room and also might be the most stubborn. He's got a terrific IQ for the game, but he's opinionated. We've seen him butt heads with coaches in high school, college, and the pros, but that certainly doesn't take away from his greatness. He's a winner, a champion, and a terrific point guard.
Well, you're right. It has fueled his rise, whether it was at Kentucky, growing up in Louisville, or certainly playing with the Boston Celtics, among some very important players, Hall of Famers like Allen and Garnett and Paul Pierce. He may have needed a little bit of that just to kind of clear the clutter and show that he could be a leader. Now, Smart. Tony Roten missing on the 3. The dish to Smart. Back to Turner. Just 4 to shoot. Olynyk inside.
Well, you allow them to get right to the rim like that. That's your only option.
Yeah, I think you got to foul them, and free throws are better than the layup.
You know, I just love Kelly Olynyk's great skill level. He can handle and shoot the ball beyond the arc, but also a polished low post score inside, so you can run offense through him, and that's really a great dynamic for his team.
And the first one drops. And so Olynyk nails both of them.
Well, as far as the league's big men go, he's one of the very best at the foul line.
Roten, the pass to Mbamute. 76ers moving the ball around. Here's Schved, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot, he'll shoot 2. That one on Smart.
And Olynyk, you look at him, he doesn't give you the impression of being the most athletic guy, but he does move well for a big guy, and his touch is exquisite around the basket. Whether shooting the hook or flipping it in with the finger roll, he finds a way to get it up and down.
I like to say stand.
And Steve Vrolinic more an offensive play. Defense something he's got to work on.
Yeah, he was foul prone last season, but I like his motor. Did better than expected on the boards. You know, he doesn't have a great wingspan, so he's not a shot blocker. But I think as he gets stronger, he can be a solid team defender.
All free throws good from Schved.
You know, the Sixers have really undergone a complete reversal in recent years from a team with a very old-school, traditional front office to a team that's now focused on the science and analytics of winning basketball. And quite honestly, guys, we're seeing more and more teams embrace the analytics side of things.
Now, here's Thornton.
2 minutes, 2 minutes
left of
the first quarter.
Oh, that's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. .156 left in the first quarter. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. And for the Sixers, their new stat-driven decision-making permeates the organization from ownership, Steve, to the front office, all the way down to the coaching staff.
Well, it's where the league seems to be going, Kevin. You know, teams are trying to think further ahead and see opportunities for strategic advantages. But, look, it's still a balance. You've got to have chemistry and coaching, and those numbers will come in play. But they can't be the be-all, end-all.
Now here's Schved. Grant kicks to Schved. Dishes it to Roten. Pass to Schved. He feeds it to Roten. Top of the key, Mbamute. From beyond the arc, no good. And the Celtics going the other way now.
In terms of rebounding, it's been a sensational opening quarter.
I like sensational. That's a good word for it.
Wallace with a screen for Smart. He dishes it to Thornton. Tries again. Kicks it to Roten. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
That's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward, Clark.
43 seconds left to play in the first. And it's Turner off the drive. He sinks the 11-footer. Turner's got his first 2 points.
Good job there, Kevin, getting himself a little space on the inside.
Here's Roten. And there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
The 76ers have been solid at the line so far, 4 for 4.
Well, last season they only hit 71% of their free throws, so this is a continuing problem, guys.
And it's something they know that if they improve, can really have a big impact on their success.
And Roten drops them both. The Celtics with the lead. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Now Smart. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. 6 on the shot clock. Thornton with it. And the Celtics hit again from deep.
4-3.
Here's Roten. And so the first quarter is in the books. It's the Celtics up by 5. The second quarter coming up right after this break, so don't go anywhere.
On and on, the on and takes
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And what do you guys think about Boston here in this one?
And the key has been the second chance points. You look at this team, the hustle that they play with, very impressive in that first quarter.
Well, it's showing up on the scoreboard. I mean, you get second chance points like that, it can add to your totals and also demoralize your opponent.
Check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter of play on the court right now for the Celtics. Turner is out there with Wallace. Then it's Thornton. Then it's Kelly Olynyk. And it's Smart in a point. And he gets it to go.
Sixers head coach Brett Brown used to coach in the Australian League. Also the former head coach of the Australian national team. So a wealth of experience in international basketball.
Marcus Smart.
The 76ers have been perfect so far from the free throw line, 6 for 6.
At the line for two.
No good on that one. Young's checked in for Marcus Thornton. No good on the second free throw.
Solid job by them on the glass here tonight. +8 in rebounding.
Well, you have to rebound to win, and that's exactly what's happening right now.
Now here's Smart. Young dishes to Turner. And it's Boston with another.
That's a nice play there. The more contributors this team can get, the better.
The 76ers trail by 9. We're about a minute into the second quarter of play. And Schved kicks to Grant. Outside Williams. 5 to shoot. Goes up to the stripe. Goes back up. The basket drops and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten in the first half here.
And I think they should really continue to work it down low, Clark. That's really going to free up the rest of their offense.
And the 76ers with some changes. Erlens Noel checks in for Mbamute. Thompson comes in for Grant. And Michael Carter-Williams subbed in for Alexei Schved. So Boston going with almost an entire new group here. Sellinger's checked in for Olynyk. Nass comes in for Wallace. Jeff Green is checked in for Turner. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Smart. Now here's Rondo. Pass to Young. Rondo kicks to Green. Back to Rondo. Three-pointer. And it's Noel with the rebound. The 76ers trail by 6. Carter Williams with it. He's picked up by Rondo. Rondo against Carter Williams. And Moultrie kicks to Carter Williams. And he gets the bucket. Carter Williams has got 6 points.
Crafty pass work there, getting it down low for the easy deuce.
Carter Williams against Rondo. He kicks it to Green. Back to Rondo. Feeds it to Green. Right side, Green with the fadeaway. Second shot opportunity, and that's 2 points on the layup. And it's 6 points for Jared Sullinger.
And are they ever working inside? Good job on the glass.
Excellent job on the glass, Steve. I agree. I mean, they're battling in there. They're fighting, they're scrapping, they're clawing, and they're getting the job done.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Well, Sixers coach Brett Brown, for 12 years an assistant with the Spurs. Coach Popovich said he, quote, lives and breathes the game. Fellow Spurs alum, Hawks coach Mike Budenholzer said he fits Philly because he's blue collar and he's a tough dude. He's demanding, but players love and respect him. Kevin?
The perfect guy to rebuild their foundation indeed. Doris, thank you. The 76ers have made 7 out of 9 when they've stepped to the line. And that one falls for Williams. Celtics leading by 3. Rondo passes to Sullinger. Jeff Green on the wing. Carter Williams covering. Clock at 6. Green left side. Foul call. Looked like the D didn't get there in time, and he'll shoot free throws. It's going to be on Nerlens Noel.
Well, kind of an interesting paradox for Jeff Green. He's much better offensively playing at the power forward spot as a spread 4, but defensively he's much better guarding 3.
And Jeff Green, not a big rebounder, struggles guarding in the low block. What do you think, Clark, is his best position?
You know, it's hard for me to say, Kevin. I think he's probably just a 3/4. I think at the 4 he has a little bit more of a quickness advantage. So I would probably look to playing him at that position.
And he's good on the second.
The main thing there was that he got them a 2-possession lead despite the 1 miss.
Cut it, and the Celtic lead has been cut down now to just 2 points with that basket from Thompson.
And there it is again. That's where their points have been coming today, from the low post.
And even under pressure in tight, they've maintained their concentration and converted their opportunities.
The drive by Green. Outside Rondo. Shot clock at 6. Back to Green. From 18 feet away. Again, the miss by Green.
And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
Rondo with it. Now defended by Carter Williams. Second shot opportunity. And Philadelphia grabs the miss.
He's one guy the defense is not afraid to leave open from that range, and for obvious reasons.
He nails it, and we're tied up. Carter Williams has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Now, you got to make a defensive adjustment here, Clark. Time to collapse inside, force the ball back out in the perimeter, make them beat you from long range.
Now, here's Green. He's got 5. Here's Sullinger. Noel with the block. They recover it. The shot by Sullinger, wide open. Good. And it's Rondo who picks up the assist. For Philadelphia, they've gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second quarter. Carter Williams dishes to Noel. And there's the feed to Williams. The rebound by Young.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
That's good. And now a 4-point Celtic lead.
I'd say that shot was well within his range.
You think so? I mean, I was pretty good from 2 feet and in myself. That's a gimme there.
And the 76ers call time here.
James Young out of Kentucky is appropriately named. He only turned 19 back in August. But he's a player with intriguing talent and potential at both ends of the floor. Good defender with long arms, natural scoring instincts and a fearlessness in his offensive game. He's got a nice stroke and takes it out to the three-point line effectively as well.
Here's what Philadelphia's going with right now. Embiid comes in for Arnett Mulch, and it's Richardson in for Thompson. Boston leading by four. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Thank you, Kevin. Brad Stevens had some words for his team over the break. He told his guys to make sure they keep the pace fast, to get out and run each and every chance they get. He also said that their work on the offensive glass is going to be critical. He believes second chance points will go a long way toward deciding this game. Well, coach not wasting any time in tweaking the game plan. We'll see if it makes a difference as we approach halftime, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thanks. And Young, 6'7", great form on his shot. The results were somewhat inconsistent at Kentucky. Is he a knockdown shooter, in your opinion?
Well, he's getting close. I mean, he's not afraid to take big shots, and he shoots it freely and with a lot of confidence. Those kind of guys can become knockdown shooters. His form, his mechanics, all good, good size. I like this guy as a pro two guard.
Now here's Carter Williams. After Jared Sullinger's miss, Richardson gets to Carter Williams. Noel sets a screen for Carter Williams. Now the pass to Noel. And it's Bradley with the rebound. Bradley's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Rondo passes to Bradley. Green kicks to Rondo. Bradley with the ball. Now defended by Carter Williams. Puts up a three. Shot is no good. And it's Philadelphia the other way. Pass to Embiid. There's the dish to Williams. Trying to get back on track. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Well, the Celtics certainly played with a lot of passion last year. They got off to a start that few thought they would achieve, but even playing with passion can't cover up the holes in the roster.
I got to give the Celtics credit, though. They were never really in contention for anything last year, but Clark, they played their heart out.
Yeah, they did play hard, played with energy, and that goes a long way to trying to build a foundation of being successful going forward. They might not have done much for them last year, but that attitude is something they can build on.
Some changes for Philadelphia. Sims has checked in, and it's Tony Roten in for Michael Carter-Williams. And Williams drops them both.
You know, he didn't get to the line in that entire first quarter, but right now he's showing some aggressiveness out there.
Bradley kicks to Green. Left side Rondo. Sullinger with a screen for Rondo. Rebound by Williams.
Even though he missed it, he couldn't pass up that chance.
Yeah, that's an easy jump shot. You got to take that one.
Dishes it to Roten. Embiid sets the pick for Roten. Bruises his man off the screen and lays it up and in. Roten's got 6 points.
Give an assist there, not for the pass, but for the solid screen set on the inside that freed him up and made the layup possible.
Rondo dishes to Sullinger. On the money from 12 feet away. Sullinger's got 6 here in this quarter.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
Now, here's Roten. He's covered by Rondo. Ball's knocked loose. Shoots a three. That's it, and the Celtic lead is cut to just 1 point on the basket from Roten.
In the first, he had trouble hitting with any consistency. But here in the second, he's turned it around.
And now, the first timeout called here for Boston.
Tony Roten, an athletic slashing guard. He got the chance to play extensively last season with the Sixers, but the lack of refinement on his jumper made him more of a volume scorer.
And the 76ers making a change here. Schved's checked in, and a new group in for the Celtics. Kelly Olynyk's checked in for Jared Sullinger. Wallace comes in for Brandon Bass. Turner's checked in for Green, and it's Thornton in for Rajon Rondo. And here is Turner. passes it to Olynyk. And a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Celtics.
How about the work on the offensive glass to this point, guys?
They also came out of the locker room with their running shoes on. I mean, their transition game has been full throttle.
And that one falls for Olynyk. And so he's able to get one of two.
Been a couple of whirlwind years for Joel Embiid. Coming from Cameroon, had to learn a new culture, new cuisine, how to drive a car. Now he's a top pick, making millions of dollars a year. That's enough to make anybody's head spin. A lot to adjust to. But with his fluidity and the natural gift he seems to have for the game, I get the feeling this young man is going to be just fine.
Here's Thornton. Following the basket by Tony Roten. Bradley kicks to Turner. Drains it from beyond the arc. Turner's got 7 points in the game.
But you can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
And Embiid with a stress fracture in his back in March, a stress fracture in his foot in June. Clark, those kinds of injuries raise long-term concerns, especially when you're talking about a seven-footer with a very limited basketball resume.
Well, there's no denying that, Kevin. I mean, clearly, if you're a general manager, then you're thinking about what are the prospects of this big, talented, highly gifted player going forward, and only time will tell if this is just an aberration or it's something that's going to be chronic.
And Bahamute's checked in for Philadelphia. Olynyk the pass to Bradley. Here's Thornton. He has 5, 4 on the shot clock. Turner dishes to Bradley. No good with the triple.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
Here's Schved, and the 76ers tack on 2 more. Boston's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Outside Bradley. And a wide-open look for Thornton. Nailed from three-point land. Thornton's got 8 points.
He got off to a slow start. It took him a little while to get into the flow of this game, but he's turned it on here in the second.
And Schved kicks to Sims. There's a screen. Now here's Roten. 11 points in the game. Schved the pass to Roten. Tried to answer back, but that three is off the mark. From the baseline. Misses off the right iron. The 76ers trail by 4. He feeds it to Emba Amute. He dishes it to Roten. Unloads. Offensive rebound. Sims. Nice defense from Waltz. Boston's gone 2 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the first. Outside Bradley. Turner dishes to Bradley. And again, Boston with the triple.
They're going back to the three-point shot over and over and over.
That was the 9th straight point from behind the arc, Clark. It feels like they're finding the holes in this defense.
Now here's Roten. Let's it go with a 3. Can't hit.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Outside Bradley. Kicks it to Olynyk. And it's Bradley off the drive. It's hauled in by the 76ers. Here's Roten. Nailed from three-point land. Roten's got a pair of triples in the second now for Philadelphia. And the first half ends in a close one. Celtics lead by 4. We'll see you after halftime for the beginning of the third quarter.